Hey folks, your OS reviews. You're watching our video first look and a quick review of a high-speed USB 2.0 hub by Kokovota. You can find this on Amazon for sub 20 bucks. And what's really interesting about this hub is just its design. It comes in a few colors that you can use to customize the look of the unit, but it's an interesting prism shape, and there's also LED lights embedded below the surface which will illuminate when plugged in. That really is quite interesting under low light environments and matches the design language of more gaming computers and more complex setups if you are looking for something that's a bit more unusual looking than your typical USB hub. Otherwise, it's a simple plug and play solution. No drivers are needed. Simply plug it in. It's going to work with Windows, with Mac computers, with Linux, also with most Android devices that support OTG, and it also acts as a fast charger, so you can also plug in a phone, and although it's not Qualcomm Quick Charge enabled, it's going to sync as well as charge up the phone in reasonable speed when it's plugged into a sufficient power source. So you can see here on the back, there are a few specs about the unit, including the fact that it has this three USB 2.0 ports, a full-size SD card slot, as well as a micro SD card slot for reading, as well as taking files out of a camera, for instance. And again, there's also rubber feet on the bottom that prevents it from sliding around. So let's open up the package and see what you get in the box. There is a quick start guide from the company, a thank you card, and then just the unit itself. So first impressions of the USB hub is that it's a lot smaller than I thought it would be just looking at it. But on second thought, it makes sense since it's simply a USB hub and doesn't really need to be super bulky to house all of these features. However, the hub itself is also quite lightweight, and one of the limitations of that is if it gets tucked on or pulled on too harshly, it will fall over and topple. However, there's again rubber feet on the bottom here that can be stuck onto a surface more permanently by removing this tape layer, and that is a nice feature to have if you want it to be more permanently set up on one particular spot. One advantage of having this vertically positioned hub is it doesn't take up too much space on a desk. So if you're limited on space but still want the desk to look quite elegant and futuristic, this is something that will work quite well. Looks like there's a bit of a sticker that I can remove here that makes the unit a bit shinier on the surface, and all the ports are nicely positioned and spaced apart, so there aren't any issues as far as plugging in multiple devices simultaneously. Otherwise, the LED lights will come on at these junction points. They don't really look like it when it's fully powered off, but they're hidden and will turn on automatically. This shape really is quite interesting and unique and eye-catching. It reminds me of the HTC Touch Diamond, if you guys still remember that. A very early phone now that was running on Windows Mobile. Back then, when it first came out, it was hyped to be a competitor with the iPhone. So that's very interesting in terms of the artsy overall look. The cable here is quite rigid, it feels strong enough, and the USB lead is also rigid and well protected. Really matches the design language of some gaming keyboards that we've seen lately, so seems to match with that entire vibe. Should work quite well with any desktop setup. Plugging things in, it actually works quite well. You really do have to remove the adhesive tape on the bottom of the base to position it more firmly on a desk surface, but afterwards, this is what it looks like, and the LED lights are also slightly cooler than I expected. It's a pulsing light that changes between the seven colors that can be changed with the primary, created with the primary colors, and again, it comes alive under low light environments. Slightly and gently goes through again all of the primary colors. There's no other ways to really change how these lights are displayed in terms of the syncing of the lights or the order of the lights, but overall, again, it does work fairly well. It's pretty gentle and acts as a nice mood light if you want it as well in your room. In terms of performance, it's a USB 2.0 hub, which is a little bit disappointing in retrospect. It could have been better with USB 3.0 speed since that technology has been out for quite a long time now. So it's not quite as high speed as you might, you know, really want if you are constantly transferring large files between a supported PC or computer, but it still works nonetheless for charging and basic tasks. So if we have a few demo devices here, such as a nano receiver that contains a keyboard or a mouse on the other side, I can simply insert it onto this one end, and when this is plugged into my computer, it will simply recognize that, and then I can use the keyboard wirelessly. So pretty no frills and simple. The full-size SD card reader here is also pretty simple to use, but it sticks out at this angle, so it doesn't sit all the way flush, something to quickly keep in mind. And the same thing goes with the micro SD card reader. There's a slight slant, and it's going to push out at the slight angle. It's not going to be completely flush with the surface of the unit. Otherwise, as far as reading thumb drives and other accessories, as far as charging it with a sync cable that might be plugged into a phone on the other side, it also worked without any issues. The computer recognized that immediately, and I could transfer any of my files without any hiccups, and same thing with charging. A note on charging though is an average Android device will charge up in roughly 3 to 4 hours, which is slightly longer than it would take on a regular wall charger that's maybe Qualcomm enabled. It might take only 1.5 hours. So it's going to be slightly longer as well since it's not meant as a dedicated charger, but syncing files worked without any issues on any of the platforms that I tested it with. So all in all, you're really paying for this unique design and this all-in-one finish as well. Overall, I think it is worth the money if you're looking for a cool conversation starter. Although it doesn't pack the fastest USB 3.0 file transfer speeds, it works well enough for general purposes. You can check out more details about this USB hub in our official written review, but for now, this has been our video. Thanks for watching here at OS Reviews. This is the Kokovota USB 2.0.